To God be the glory for the great things he had. Put your hands together if you're really glad to be in the house on this evening. Could you all do me a favor? When we come to worship, could we stop acting so sophisticated? Amen, somebody. Can we really clap our hands to the Lord? Some of y'all been watching March Madness, your favorite movie stories. You all, this is a high time for the Christian church. This is a time where we reflect and we remember what Jesus Christ went through and what he did to purchase our salvation. Is there really anybody excited about what he did? Are you grateful at least for what he did? This is a time where we remember. This is either dubbed as Palm Sunday, some of us have on our palms, or Passion Sunday. The start of that Palm Sunday represents Jesus riding to Jerusalem on a donkey, his triumphal entry into Jerusalem. But we also need to remember Passion, the tragic events that happened to him on that day, at the end of that week, starting on that Monday, Thursday. But we are going to reflect today on both of them, because at one Sunday, the crowd was crying, Hosanna. On that Friday, they were crying, crucify him. But then on the next Sunday, they were saying, he is risen. And so therefore, we can look back with a voice and a mind of celebration to tell, thank you, God. Yes, they cried, Hosanna. Yes, they cried, crucify you. But thank God you rose on that third day morning. Amen, somebody. So this is the first Sunday of Holy Week. This is a sanctified week, amen. No matter what you've gone through, no matter what you've been through, no matter how you're feeling, let's turn our attention to God. So therefore, on today, with special emphasis on Holy Week, amen, we're going to ask Dr. Jonay to come first with a prayer of adoration. We're going to start this prayer. We're going to do things a little differently. I mean, our men are going to come, but we're going to start this service. I want to give you a little instructions. Amen. She's going to give a short prayer of adoration. Then Alandra will come with the call to worship. Facebook family and friends, we thank God for you being with us on today. Those who will tune in by YouTube, thank you for tuning in and sharing in this worship experience. We ask you to like, heart, comment, and share this worship experience. Those who are sick, bereaved, we want you to know we are praying for you, Sister Mitchell. We are praying for you, Sister Rakia. We thank God for your successful eye surgery, and all those who are listening, all those who are tuned in, all of our sick, amen. And so therefore, before we start and before they come, I want to ask you to participate with me to do two things. I want all of us to raise your voice and cry, Hosanna, Hosanna. Wait a minute, I'm giving y'all instructions. I want you all to cry with me three times, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Come on, let's say it together. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Now, hallelujah, amen. You feel something when you do that, right? So the next thing I want you to do, I want you to cry out loud. This may be a little uncomfortable for some of y'all. Crucify him. Crucify him. Crucify him. Come on, let's say it together. Crucify. Crucify him. Crucify him. Now, I wanted you to feel that because it was difficult to say crucify other than Hosanna. And as we go throughout this worship experience, I want you to know and choose which crowd you're going to be in. Are you going to be in the crowd that says Hosanna? Hosanna? Hosanna, or are you in the crowd that says, crucify him, crucify him, crucify him? And we'll talk about that a little later. But open your hearts and your ears to what the Spirit has to say. to receive what God is about to do. Come on, Dr. Jonay, and then Minister in Training, Alandra Barbour. Alandra will come. Gilbert will come.
Thank you, Pastor. May we bow our heads. Oh, Lord Jesus Christ, on this day you received the worship of those who hailed you as their King. Accept our praise and adoration, our worship and love, and grant that we who now confess you with our lips may never fail to give you the service of our lives for the honor of your holy name. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen.
As we were called into worship today, it is sobering to remember that when God appeared on earth in the person of Jesus, most of the world did not recognize him and therefore did not worship him. Today we ask for faith that will open our eyes to see Jesus for who he is, that we might worship him in truth. People of God, behold to see your God. We open our eyes to see his glory. We open our ears to hear his wisdom. We open our hands to offer him gifts. We open our mouths to sing him praise, my God. We open our hearts to offer him our love. He is Lord. 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 My God, he is Lord. Now we have our deacons to come and give out and give prayer and scripture. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hosanna. 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 Good morning, church. I'd like to call your attention to this morning's scripture reading. I'll be reading from St. Matthew's, the 21st chapter. I'll be reading 11 verses as Jesus rides into Jerusalem. And when they drew near unto Jerusalem and were come to Bethany unto the Mount of Olives, they sent Jesus two disciples, saying unto them, go into the village over against you, and straightway ye shall find an ass tied and a goat with her. Loose them and bring them unto me. And if any man say aught unto you, ye shall say, the Lord has need for them. And straightway he will send them. And this was done, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, saying, tell ye the daughter of Sion, behold, thy king come unto thee, meek and seated upon an ass, and the coat of foal of an ass. And the disciples went and did as Jesus commanded them, and brought the ass and the coat, and put on them their clothes, and they set him thereon. And a very great multitude spread their garments in their way. Others cut down branches from the trees and strawed them in the way. And the multitude that went before that followed cried, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. And when he had come into Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, who is this? And the multitude said, this is Jesus, the prophet of Nazareth of Galilee. May it be a blessing on the reader and the hearer of these words.
Amen. 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 bowed our heads in prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father, I come to say thank you. Thank you, oh, Heavenly Father, for this day, oh, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Father, for this church, Father, and this board of members, oh, Heavenly Father. Bless us collectively, one by one, Father. Father, bless all the churches that stand in your name, Heavenly Father. Please have mercy, oh, Heavenly Father. Bless the sick, Father, all over this land and country, oh, Heavenly Father. Touch the little ones, oh, Heavenly Father, all over the world, all over in foreign lands, Father. Because there's a lot of evil that's going on in that area, oh, Heavenly Father. The bombings, oh, Heavenly Father, that killed 130 people, including children, oh, Heavenly Father. And, Father, bless that young, the father of that young man, 2 years old, Father. His mama shielded him, Father, from the bomb that killed her, but saved his son, oh, Heavenly Father. Please have mercy, oh, Heavenly Father. We need prayer, oh, Heavenly Father, right now, all over this land and country, oh, Heavenly Father. Please have mercy, Father. I know you know, oh, Heavenly Father, what's going on, oh, Heavenly Father. But, Father, everything is in your hands right now, oh, Heavenly Father. You reign on the just as well as on the unjust, oh, Heavenly Father. Bless, Father, not just Gary, oh, Heavenly Father, but all over, Father, we need the blessing right now, Father. We've been crying and stumbling, oh, Heavenly Father. Please, oh, Heavenly Father, bless our leaders here, oh, Heavenly Father. Oh, Lord, can then they make the right decision, oh, Heavenly Father. Please, oh, have mercy. Gary needs a lift up, oh, Heavenly Father. I know it's coming, oh, Heavenly Father. Please, oh, have mercy, oh, Heavenly Father. Bless our presidents, oh, Heavenly Father, that's running in his race, oh, Heavenly Father. You know, Father, you are in charge of them also, Heavenly Father. They're not doing right, but in your eyesight, they're going to suffer, oh, Heavenly Father. Please, oh, have mercy, oh, Heavenly Father. Bless the young people right here, oh, Heavenly Father. Give them strength, God. Please, oh, have mercy. Oh, Lord, I know you can bless them, oh, Heavenly Father. You said, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not to. It's the kingdom of God is at hand, oh, Heavenly Father. We got to get on our knees right now, right now. We can't be ashamed of God. Please, oh, have mercy. We can't be ashamed of the Lord. Lord, judge us right now, oh, Heavenly Father. Father, get it on my heart, oh, Heavenly Father. I'm not ashamed to own you, oh, Heavenly Father. You brought me my mind a long way, oh, Heavenly Father. You touch me right now, oh, Heavenly Father. Oh, you touch me, God. You don't touch my eyes, oh, Heavenly Father. I might not have 20/20 vision, but Lord, you won't guide me through the streets, oh, Father. You're going to guide me at night, oh, Heavenly Father. You're going to put a shield on my heart. Oh, Lord, please, oh, have mercy. Oh, touch us right now. Oh, yeah. Touch every church, oh. Oh, touch every preacher, oh, Heavenly Father. Oh, where they can preach the undeserved gospel, Father. Please, oh, have mercy. Father, when it's all over down here, meet us in that dying hour where we can put our head on the breast of us. Bring our life out sweetly there. These and many other blessings I ask. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hosanna! Hosanna! Come on with me. Hosanna! Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah.
Come on, y'all know this. Good morning, Jesus. Good morning, Jesus. So glad you're here. Good morning, Jesus. You're welcome. You're welcome. There goes my burden. There goes my fear. Good morning, Jesus. So glad you're here. Good morning, Jesus. Good morning, Jesus. Oh, glad you're here. Good morning, Jesus. You're welcome. You're welcome. There goes my burden. There goes my burden. There goes my fear. Good morning, Jesus. So glad you're here. He is the King of Kings. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord. We're going to say it more times. His name is Jesus. 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 He is the King of Kings. He is the King. He is the King. Of King, He is the Lord of Lords. His name is Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. He is the King of. What a mighty God! What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve, angels bow before Him, heaven and earth adore Him, what a mighty God we serve, what a mighty God, what a mighty God we serve, what a mighty God we serve. We serve angels bow before Him. Heaven and earth adore Him. What a mighty God we in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We have the victory. Oh yeah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Satan, tell me who can stand before us. Tell me who can stand before. When we call on that great name. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus. We have the victory. Good morning, Jesus. Good morning, Jesus. So glad you're here. Good morning, Jesus. You're welcome, Jesus. There goes my burden. There goes my fear. Good morning, Jesus. So glad you're here. What a mighty God. What a mighty God. We serve. Do you serve Him? Come on now. What a mighty God. We serve. We serve. Angels bow before Him. Heaven and earth adore Him. Angels bow before Him. Heaven and earth adore Him. What a mighty God. We serve. In the name. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we have the victory. Oh yeah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Satan will have to flee. Oh, who can stand before us? When we call on that great name, Jesus.
Jesus.
What's the name?
Jesus.
Precious.
Jesus.
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 We have
the victory. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Our pastor came in and he mentioned the word Hosanna. So there's a little song that says, Hosanna in the highest. Can we just worship? Let our King be lifted up. Hosanna. I'm going to teach it to you. Sing it with me. It goes, Hosanna in the highest. In the highest. Let our King be lifted up. That's the whole song. Hosanna. Now can we just worship and lift our hands? Say Hosanna. Hosanna. In the highest. In the highest. Let our King be lifted up. Hosanna, Hosanna. Come on, New Revelation, lift your hands. We're going a little bit higher. Oh, say Hosanna in the highest. Highest. Let our King be lifted up. Hosanna, Hosanna. Now I want to hear your voices singing. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest, in the high. Let our King be lifted. Let our King be lifted up. Let our King one more time. Let our King be lifted one last time. Let our King be lifted up. Hosanna, Hosanna.
Good morning, New Revelation. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. If we have any visitors in the house, could you please stand, remain standing for the welcome. On behalf of Pastor Turner and the entire New Revelation Church family, we welcome you. If you're looking for a church home, and if you're looking for some of the best teaching and some of the best preaching this side of heaven, you have found it. If you're just visiting, we thank you, and we hope that you come back and visit with us again and again and again. Thank you. You may be seated.
Come on, let's finish that chorus. Let our King,
let our King be lifted up.
Say Hosanna,
Hosanna.
Clap those hands and give Jesus praise in the house. Come on, let's stand to our feet all over the building as we sing our congregational hymn. Let's sing the verse.
At last, and then my Savior, and then my sovereign God,
would he devote?
Would he devote that sacred head for such a work?
Come on, let's go to at the cross. Say,
at the cross, where I first and
say it was there. Let's say that one more time.
Say at the cross. Say.
Rode away.
It was.
I received my sight,
and now.
Come on, let's have a little church at the cross.
At the cross, where I first saw the light. And the burdens of my heart rolled.
It was there.
Amen. How many of you know it was at the cross? Are you still looking at the cross? Amen. There's a little story about a person that got lost, a young lady that got lost. And the moral of the story is they asked her, can you find your way home? Do you know your address? She said, no, I don't know my address. She said, what do you know? He said, there's this steeple. Somebody heard the story in the neighborhood, and it has a cross on top of the steeple. And if you could just get me, somebody understand where I can see the cross on the steeple, I can find my way home. And is there anybody in the house know you ever been lost in this world? You ever been lost in your mind, lost in your spirit? But all I needed to see was the cross. It was a sign of suffering and shame, but it was also a sign of hope. Does anybody in the house have hope? Hallelujah. Our hope, I'm not dealing with hopeless people. Amen. Because you showed up at a house of hope. No matter what you've been through, no matter what's tried to discourage you, no matter what's tried to frustrate you, remember, this is a week of celebration. Not only is it triumphal. Do I have any people that got some good news on this week? See, we always coming in church, Adrian, talking about the bad news. But is there anybody got some good news? And you can celebrate your good news. Guess what? If you ain't got no news, that's good news. How many of you know if I ain't got no news, no doctor's report, no nothing, that's some good news, because I'm so glad that things could be worse than what they are. But thank you, God, for how good they are. Anybody can celebrate God for things being as good as they are? Because I realize they could be a little worse. I don't have to be where I am today. I don't have to feel the way I feel. But I thank God that God is a God of triumph. And because I'm his child, I am triumphant. Amen, somebody. But for those who can't get excited, amen. We're going to pray for you this morning. Because I'm assuming, based upon your expressions or your lack of expression, that you got some problems going on. Because the last time I checked, the Bible says, enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Enter into his courts with praise. Watch this. Be thankful. Do I have any thankful? It says be thankful. That means that thankfulness, Tanya, is a part of my being. Somebody missed what I... Thankfulness is a part of my being. So it does not matter what's going on. This is the day that the Lord has made. And because I have a thankful being, I'm going to rejoice and be glad. And anybody thankful in the house? Hallelujah. We're going to cancel the assignment of the enemy. Because the enemy is trying to discourage somebody. Because you got sickness in your body. The enemy is trying to discourage somebody because you experienced death in your family. But devil, we came to serve you. Notice that we will not be subject to what's going on. But I will bless the Lord because my praise is not predicated on what I'm going through. My praise is predicated on who you are. And when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, I get excited. Thank you, Lord, for blessing me. Ain't he all right? Hallelujah. 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 Hosanna. Hosanna. Hallelujah. Hosanna. Glory to your name. You're a great God. I'm just worshiping. Don't worry about me, y'all. I'm just giving God my praise. I'm giving him my word. He's worthy. It doesn't matter what I went through. It's about where I am. And I thank God that what I went through did not take me out. But God is great. Hallelujah. He's greatly. Ain't he all right? Hallelujah. Somebody say, Reverend, it don't take all of that. Why you doing all that hollering? You don't need to do all that. But that may be for you, amen. But you don't know my story. You don't know where I've been. And when I look at you, you act like you ain't been nowhere. But if I have anybody in the house that lived at least 50 years, that when you think back over your life, you know you should have been dead. You should have been in an accident, but thank God. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm still here. I may not move as fast, but I'm still here. My knees may hurt here. I may not think as quickly as I used to think, but I'm still here. Yeah. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. He's worthy, y'all. He's worthy. And I know it says for altar prayer, amen. But if you're going to come to the altar, you got to come with a thankful spirit. Because we're not going to beg God for nothing today. We just going to thank him for what he's already done. Anybody got to come on to the altar if you want to. But say, neighbor, if you don't have a thankful spirit, just stay in your seat. Father God, we come like we lost our mind. We've come, oh God, with a crazy praise. We've come with a thankful spirit because you've been so good to us. Father, we didn't come to beg you for nothing, but we come to thank you for everything. Thank you for the good. Thank you for bringing us through. Father, our testimony, our praise is a sign to somebody else that's going through right now. That if we hold on, weeping may endure, will come. If you just hold on, thank you for being our friend. Thank you for having a strong hand that we can hold on to. Thank you, oh God, for being a healer. Thank you, God, for being a protector. Thank you, God, for being a provider. Thank you for being a deliverer. And your word says, let the redeemed say so, whom he has redeemed from the hand of the enemy. And so we just a few redeemed folk, oh God, that don't mind giving you a praise. We don't mind being thankful. We don't mind being grateful for all that we've been through, for all that we've done. We are stronger. We are wiser. We are better. And we just cry out, Hosanna, Hosanna. Glory be to God. You are a great God. You are a worthy God. We lift your name. We lift it on high because you're worthy to be praised. We just stand around the altar. We're going to lift our hands and we're going to tell the Lord, thank you. Thank you, Lord, for your son Jesus that died on the cross. He rose 3 days later. But thank you, God, for the Holy Spirit that leads us and guides us and seals us until the day of redemption. And before we close this prayer, dear God, we thank you that one of these old days, Jesus is coming back for his church without a spot or wrinkle. No more crying, no more dying. We are going to a better place, and we seal this prayer in the name that's above every name. Demons tremble at that name. Cancer is healed at that name. Sickness is healed at that name. Depression, it gotta leave at that name. In the name of Jesus, let the church say amen. When you go back to your seat, tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, let's put a praise on it, because I'm thankful, I'm grateful for what God has done. Say yeah, oh yeah. Thank you.
To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory for all the things He's done. He's done. If I were you, I would get what I needed from the Lord on today. If I were you, I would get what I needed from the Lord in this moment. His presence is here, and I'll tell you, whatever it is that you need from Him, all you got to do is lift your hands, give Him glory, and receive it by faith. Somebody came in not feeling the best in their body. I dare you to lift your hands and by faith receive your healing, receive whatever it is that you need. We don't shout and praise just for nothing. We don't do this because we have nothing better to do. But we do this, one, because He's good and because He's God. And we do it because He deserves the glory, the honor, and the praise. The other reason that we do it is that it strengthens our faith, that whatever we may be going through and whatever we may be dealing with in our lives, in the midst of our praise, God has a way of working things out on your behalf, even in the midst of your praise. Can somebody just take the next few seconds? The clapping of the hands is wonderful, but I wonder how many will offer Him the fruit of your lips just for the next few seconds. How many will take a moment and just speak well of Him in the house? God, you're great. God, you're awesome. God, you're wonderful. You're omnipotent. You're El Shaddai. You're Elohim. You're Jehovah Jireh. Awesome in all your ways. Marvelous are your works. Come on, take a moment and just bless Him. We're going to sing a song, but He seeketh such that will touch His heart with your voice right now in this moment. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We don't need to hide behind no music. Somebody just fill this atmosphere with words of worship.
Hallelujah.
He's doing something in a room, and we're going to wait a moment for you. Somebody came needing God to do it. Somebody came desperate. Desperate for your healing, desperate for your blessing. And His presence is here. And what better time is there than now? With my hands lifted up and my mouth filled with praise. We're going to move. But with a heart of thanksgiving, I will bless Thee, O Lord. Church says, with my hands lifted up and my mouth filled with praise. With a heart of thanksgiving. With a heart of thanksgiving. Make it personal and say, I will bless Thee, O Lord. We're going to move, but say, I will bless Thee, O Lord. I will bless Thee, O Lord. With everything that I have, I will bless Thee, O Lord. with a heart of I will bless, I will. I promise we're moving, but say it just one more time. I will bless thee, oh. I will. With a heart of. That's enough right there. I will bless thee, oh
because he lives. and feel the pride.
The whole church says,
because he lives,
all of my fear is gone because he lives. Life is worth the living just because. All of my early problems are fixing. Oh, I can sing and I can shout because he lives. Anybody glad about the fact that he lives? Yeah, because he lives. Because he lives. Yeah, oh, he lives. Come on, because he lives. Satan is defeated and God is exalted because he lives. Death is swallowed up in victory because he lives. Because he lives, because he lives, because he lives. We are free to worship and free to praise.
Because he lives.
Because he lives.
Because he lives.
How many of you believe that it is your season to be blessed? It's your season to be blessed. God made you a promise, and you stood the test. He's gonna open up a window and pour you a blessing. It's your season to be blessed. Come on, help me now. To be blessed. God made you a promise. You stood dead. Gonna open up a window. Pour you out a blessing. It's your season to be blessed. You know what? I'm blessed in the city. I'm blessed in the field. I'm blessed coming out. And I'm blessed coming in. He's gonna open up a window and pour you out a blessing. It's your season to be blessed. It's your season. God made you a promise. You stood, gonna open up a window, and pour you out a blessing. It's your season to be blessed. I've been through the fire. And I've been through the flood. But you know what? I'm standing here only because of his blood. He's gonna open up a window and pour you out a blessing. It's your season to be blessed. Oh, it's your season. To be blessed. God made you a promise. You stood the test. He gonna open up a window, and pour you out a blessing. It's your season. It's your season. God made you that promise. And he's faithful and just to keep it. It's your season. He brought you this far. He wouldn't leave you. It's your season.
These singing men a hand. Let's thank God for them and Brother Bernie for the leadership that he gives them. Amen. For their dedication to being prepared on this fourth Sunday. Amen. It's good to have diverse worship, something that everybody can receive. And we do our best to have diversity in worship. Amen. It's just good to have men that still want to participate. Amen. So really, we all need encouraging in the body of Christ, telling you no matter what we've done and what you do, but for people who are willing worshipers, people who are willing to rehearse, practice, and come out to get the best sound possible at that time. Amen. It's a blessing. Amen. So we never want to discount what people do. All of us are part of the body of Christ. Hopefully you've got something through the worship thus far. If it's not, if you have not, it lets me know what crowd you're part of. You either on the Hosanna side or you're on the crucify him side. And so I want to share with you this morning, if you're interested, from the 12th chapter of John's Gospel, John 12. And John is one of the gospel writers. We have four gospel writers. Three of them are called the synoptic gospel writers. And John stands alone, because when you look at the three, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, they have similar writings. That's why they are called synoptic. But then John stands alone because he's interested in helping us to understand that Jesus is divine as well as human. He helps us to see his divinity. Amen. And so therefore, as we look at this particular gospel writing, we're going to share in the way as they're getting the screen prepared. If you have your own, that's why you need to carry your own personal copy of God's executive order. Amen. You never know when technology is going to mess up. Amen. And so therefore they have it now for your comfort. The 12th chapter of John, the 12th through the 16th verse, and we'll read two other verses. It says like this: the next day, a great multitude that had come to the feast, when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. Amen. Took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him and cried out, what? Hosanna. Blessed is he who is to come in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel. Then Jesus, when he had found a young donkey, sat on it, as it is written, fear not, daughter of Zion. Behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's coat. His disciples did not understand these things at first, but when Jesus was glorified, then they remembered that these things were written about him and that they had done these things to him. Now we're going to go skip down to verse 35 and verse 36. Then Jesus said to them, a little while longer, the light is with you. Walk while you have the light, lest darkness overtake you. He who walks in darkness does not know where he is going. While you have the light, believe in the light, that you may become sons or children of light. These things Jesus spoke and departed and was hidden from them. Amen. I want to talk about from this thought today, let the light in your life. Let the light in your life. Y'all, some of you may not be like me, but when I wake up in the morning and the sun is shining and I get up, I go to the blinds. I go to the curtains because I've been in darkness all night. And so now it's time to let some light in. Come on, dear, help me preach. Amen. Some people like darkness. I'm not judging you or saying anything about you, but some people like darkness. But I just believe that if I've been in darkness all night, when the sun comes out, I should enjoy the glory of the sun. So I open my windows and I let the light come in my house, in my bedroom, in the living room, in the kitchen, especially because that's where my plant is and it needs some light. And so therefore, when I thought about this, I thought about how many of us, I stated if you're interested, how many of you have really let the light in your life? When I'm talking about light, light always in the Bible gives off the indication of truth. Y'all rolling with me? The truth, amen. It gives the understanding that you have some awareness of what's going on. That's why we hear that word to enlighten. Hopefully those who are listening and will take hold, you're being enlightened. That means you are allowing the light of the truth to come in your life. So many people, Brother John Holloway III, they don't want the truth. Y'all remember that movie, The Truth? You can't handle the truth, amen. Most people can't handle the truth, amen. They don't know what to do with the truth. So since they can't handle it, Deacon Robinson, what do? They deny it. They don't accept it. Preach, Turner. Amen, somebody. So therefore, most of us that sit in church or come to the building, you are enlightened. Y'all roll with me for a little while. You are being enlightened. And when you leave out of those doors and live your everyday life, are you shining or are you dark? Amen, somebody. And the reality of it is that when you look at a light, Sister Geraldine, evangelist in training, amen. She said some years ago in Bible study that a light shines at different wattages. Some of us are still shining at 5 watts. And we've been in the church 50 years. Some of us are still shining at 3 watts. And we've been saying we love the Lord. Amen, somebody. So have you really let the light in your life? Or are you just a pretender? Thinking that I am light, Preach Turner, just because I show up at the lighthouse. Preach, turn. Amen, somebody. And so therefore, I pray today that I want to urge you and exhort you to let the light. Now watch this. Look at the verbiage I'm using. Let the definite article for those who are school teachers and understand English. Not a light. Because some of us allow a light and not the light to enter into our life. And it's all right. Guess what? As long as you have the light to combat a light, we are supposed to weigh everything against the word of God. I know y'all don't want to hear this. Amen. In our lives, what am I going to allow? That's why I know how to reject Tanya, some light. Because I know it's not the light. Because the word of God is the truth and the, y'all read your Bible, amen. So therefore, let me give you a few nuggets about what's happening in our chapter today. You really have to go back to chapter 11. I probably do more teaching than holler. I already hollered enough, amen. Hopefully this true teaching to help y'all holler. Some of y'all sit too quiet anyway, amen. So you have to go back to chapter 11. As I stated earlier, this is what we call Palm Sunday Passion Week. I wore red today because some of you wondering why I probably got on this red robe and the men in their brown. And I try to match the people that's singing. But I realized that I am wearing the colors of the liturgical calendar. The liturgical calendar says that Palm Sunday, you wear red because red symbolizes the blood. It symbolizes fire. I'm teaching y'all. I'm enlightening y'all now. Amen. Fire and the martyrs that died as Christians. So this is part of the liturgical calendar. So I read in honor of the blood, the fire, and those martyrs that died. Because this is Palm Sunday and also Passion Week. Palm Sunday, as I stated earlier, for those who weren't here, it represents and it tends to have people to focus on the triumphal entry of Jesus into Jerusalem. Most people don't know this. This is Jesus' first time back in Jerusalem until he died. Until his birth. He hadn't been back to Jerusalem until this time. Because now he's preparing Sister Lynette for his death. He was always making his way to Jerusalem. From the day of his birth, he lived in Galilee. He was born in Nazareth. He made his hometown, his headquarters in Galilee. He never came back to Jerusalem. I'm enlightening y'all. Until his death, if you're interested. And so as Jesus was making his way to Jerusalem, you have to go back and read chapter 11, because chapter 11, go home and read it, and y'all can ask me some questions at Bible study. Chapter 11, it talks about an experience of Jesus raising a dead man from the grave. Y'all remember Lazarus? Sister Mary, the brother of Mary and Martha? Jesus raised him from the dead. Y'all roll with me a little while. He raised him from the dead because by this time, Jesus' popularity had spread. People had heard about him healing the sick, raising the dead, all of these type of things, opening blind eyes, feeding the hungry 5,000 with the boys' lunch, two little fish and five biscuits. He fed them. They heard about all this stuff. Now, it seems, Dana, as he's making his way back to Jerusalem, that the last miracle that he performed was raising Lazarus from the dead. And after he raised Lazarus from the dead, I don't want to spoil the story, so y'all go home and read it. Amen. All the way to the end of the verse, what happened was some people that were around him went back and told the chief priest and the Pharisees about this, what this man was doing. Let me tell y'all something. The Jews, which Jesus was a Jew, had a problem with their own kind. Oh, I wish I had time to preach about that. How many of us got a problem with our own kind? That's another story. Amen, somebody. So what happened was, Carmelita, some of them told the chief priest, y'all know Jesus? Let me just make it plain. This man, now he didn't raise Lazarus from the dead. People are starting to really catch on to who he is. Believe him, y'all. Don't mind. Go home and read it. He said, what are we going to do about this? Because the Roman government, it's going to come and mess with us. Guess what, y'all? The Jews had a collaboration with the Roman government. And Jesus was coming to mess up what they had already established. I wish y'all understand. See, you can't spiritualize everything. Some things are political. I wish somebody understand. The Jews, that if the Rome come up, they're going to come and mess with us. They're going to stop us from being who we are. And we don't want no trouble. So we got to do something with this man. We got to kill him. Something has to happen to him because people were starting to follow him, talking about he's the king of the Jews. We already got a king. Now he's talking about he's the king of the Jews. Y'all getting it? So Rome gonna mess with us. Go home and read it. It's right there at the end of chapter 11. Then by the time we get to chapter 12, verse 1 says, now 6 days from the Passover feast. That's the feast it's talking about. The Passover feast, for some of y'all who need to understand, I'm just enlightening. It's the Old Testament in Exodus when the Lord delivered the Jews, the Israelites, from the hand of Pharaoh. Y'all remember that? Everything that Yahweh did, as far as the frogs, the snake, everything that Pharaoh did, Yahweh did, Pharaoh had his magicians and his diviners to copy what Yahweh did. Let me tell y'all something. There are different spirits out there. And you got to be very careful. I didn't mean to say this, amen. But you got to be very careful for people talking about they can read the future. That means they're operating in the spirit of divination. Because God is not doesn't give me the ability, watch this, Deacon McGee, to tell you that you're going to have a whole lot of money. Tell me this is going to happen. That's, you got to be very careful with that type of thing, because that's also the spirit of divination. What Yahweh do, guess what? Other spirits can do. There's a whole lot of spirits operating out here. I wish somebody understand. But it was one thing. Somebody say one thing. It was the death. So what Moses told the people to do, go home and put the blood of the lamb on the doorpost. I know Pharaoh think he got up, went up on me, but there's one thing he can't do, amen. He said, put the blood of an unblemished lamb over the doorpost. And when the death angel come, it will pass by your house. Amen, I'm getting happy right along through here because I didn't mean to go that way, but I'm so glad that's why I got the blood on me. Amen. That's why death can't overtake. I'm not talking about physical death. Amen. Because yes, I'm going to die physically. But how many of you know that even if I die physically, I'm not going to be separated from God? Death is nothing but separation. And you got to be enlightened. You got to have light in order to be a part of the light. We're going to get to that. So the death angel came and Pharaoh let the people go. So the Jews would celebrate you all. The Passover feast, even until this day, they celebrate Passover. And so now, Dana, in the New Testament, right here in chapter 12, the feast was about to happen. 6 days from the feast was going to happen, you all. 6 days, and Passover was going to start. And so what's happening in this text, go home and read all of this. I really wish I could just really walk through it like I want to, but I'm trying in my mind as the Holy Spirit is telling me what to say, what to cut across the field at. Amen, somebody. So that you go home and read it and you'll see how Jesus is saying this has to happen. This is going to happen. He says then he was at Jesus after he left that area. He went to Mary and Martha and Lazarus' house. Lazarus was now sitting at the table. Y'all rolling with me? He was sitting at the table and Mary, what she did was she took some expensive cologne. Y'all remember this story? Anointed Jesus' feet and wiped his feet with her hair. Then heckle old Judas. Judas said, wait a minute. That's some expensive perfume. Some Bond number 9. Some Angel. Whatever y'all got. Amen. We could have sold this and gave the money to the poor. But the Bible said Jesus wasn't concerned about giving money to the poor because he was the treasurer of the group. He knew if he sold the money, I mean the perfume, he said then the money went in the bag and he was controlling the bag. Now I'm not talking about everybody, but you got to watch some of these treasurers. People that try to control the money, amen, somebody. You got to watch their motive. But Judas was saying, watch this. He said, it's not about that. He said, leave her alone. In essence, she's preparing me for my death. I wish somebody understood the word. Go home and read it. Amen. Then it goes on down, and then Jesus began to talk about a whole lot of things. Go home and read it. I don't want to spoil your appetite. Amen. And so, but what happens is, by the time we get right here to verse number 12, Jesus began to now come into the people. Wait, no, some Jews came. They said, we want to see Jesus. Not Jews, I'm sorry, some Greeks. Some Greeks came, and they said, we want to see Jesus. We want to see who this man is. And then Andrew went and told Philip, he said, there are some outsiders here that want to see this man named Jesus. And so they went and told Jesus, and Jesus said, it is my time in essence. And he says, now Jesus comes into Jerusalem riding on a donkey. Amen, somebody. He's riding on this ass as the scripture is written. Amen, somebody. He's doing nothing but fulfilling the word of God. And the word of God, he's not doing it to fulfill it. I want us to understand that. It's just happening, so it will be fulfilled. There's just like some stuff happening in your life. Some people may have told you some stuff. I heard we were at Dr. Baltimore's thing last week, and his cousin said, this is the man that his father said he would travel the world. And when you know God has told you something, you know, sometimes people, I don't say this often, I dare to say it now, I didn't know what this meant, but I remember the Lord told me some time ago, I was washing the sink out, Brother John, over there at your wash house on Broadway, when I was a janitor at the mill, and I was washing out, I was a janitor. He said, I'm going to make your name great among names. And I said, Lord, why me? And I started crying. Sister Wilson, I said, I was a janitor. Listen to what I'm saying. And the Lord said, I'm going to make your name great among names. He didn't say over names. And then I'm like, what does that mean? And I didn't think about anything. And I went on and I just didn't worry about that. Then I found myself at the convention one year and it was in 2010. And I remember I was at the winter board meeting and somebody called me up to pray. And they said to me, they said, we're going to have Reverend Turner from Indiana to come up and pray. And I sent by McDonald, Raymond McDonald, when he was still alive. I said, did he just call me? He said, that's your name, ain't it? So I went up there and I prayed and I ran and met the person outside of there, David Peoples. I said, Dr. Peoples, thank you for letting me pray over the offering. I said, my pastor taught me anything I do on the worship is not little. It's always important. He said, I just wanted people to know your name. I said, wait a minute. That's what the Lord told me. On a national level, people know your name. That was 2010. Then after that, 2013, Brother McGee, I don't know why Bishop Baltimore wanted me to preach on the national level. My name was right there by some notable names. Freddie Haynes. And Judge Mathis, I'm in the book. I can let y'all see the book if y'all think I'm lying. My name is right there with all these notable names. I said, I ain't nobody. I got this little church. And who am I? He said, remember what I told you. I'm going to make your names great among names. And when you see, guess what the Lord is doing. I know some of y'all don't hate on me, amen. I'm just telling y'all what the Lord told me. I'm just giving y'all a sneak peek in my life. I ain't mad at nobody else. I ain't mad at no piece. I'm gonna make your name great among names. Then I get to be on the board of Christian Education, starting to know Ed Turner. Then not only did I preach in 2013, then I preached late night at the convention. I don't even know how the people started knowing my name. Then they started inviting me over here. Then I start being the regional second vice president. Then I start being the regional first vice president. Now I'm the regional president. I've had to introduce some notable names, but because I introduced a notable name, my name is right there with their name. Somebody need to understand just this. On Friday, it was down for Bishop Baltimore to introduce Dr. Otis Moss. Yes, sir. He said, won't you do it in my stead? I said, Bishop, I talked about Dr. Moss so good. See, you got to know what to do when you up there. Yes, sir. Adrian, I talked about Dr. Otis Moss Sr. Yes. So good, a legend in his own right. Most of you don't even know him. Go look him up. He's the one that was right there with Dr. Martin Luther King. To run that march with him. He knew his father and everybody else down from Atlanta. I introduced him so well when he got up. He said, give me a copy of the introduction so I can give to my grandchildren. Because guess what? I know what the Lord told me. Amen. So y'all better understand. Guess what? I ain't toot my own horn. But since y'all don't understand, y'all better understand who y'all got in front of y'all. Because the Lord is and has done great things. That's not to lift me up. I'm just telling you what the Lord has done. I'm just so it's to fulfill. Watch this. It didn't happen until 10 years later. It didn't happen until 20 years later, 24 years later. But when the Lord tells you something, you better believe it. Don't you tell it to yourself. That don't mean you ought to get arrogant and pompous and this and that and act like you can't be personable no more. Act like your stuff don't stink because you got a little position, you got a little money, you got a different job. Still be who you are. A man asked me one time, he said, Turner, why aren't you arrogant? I said, I don't know. I'm just Ed Turner. I'm a grandmama's boy. I like to listen to some B.B. King. I like to listen to some Johnny Taylor. I like to listen to Aretha Franklin. I like to listen to Shirley Caesar. I better put that in the F or y'all just think I'm a heathen. I like to listen to it all. But you got to understand who you are. Because no position, no clothing, no title on your job, the size of your house, don't make you who you are. I wish I had some honest folk in the house. You got to know who you are before you buy the house. I ain't always been in a nice place in my life. But thank God, Adrian, the Lord never allowed me to look like what I was going through. And do I have anybody in the house know that the Lord had not allowed you to look like some of y'all that had it good all y'all life, because y'all didn't always have money. You didn't always grow up in a good family. Some of y'all act like y'all had it good all y'all life. But can anybody thank God, even if you had it good, thank God for the goodness? But I still haven't lost who I was. I didn't mean to go there. Amen, somebody. It was just a fulfillment. Because there are some people who will say, well, they just acting the Bible out. No, it's not an act. It is the fulfillment of what God has said. And the Bible said the next day when the large crowd came, now the people watched this asking to see Jesus. It said when the large crowd came to the festival, they heard that Jesus was coming. Give me 10 more minutes. They heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. So what they did was take palm branches and went out to meet him, shouting, Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Watch this. Here's the controversy. The King of Israel. They already got a king. We got to get rid of this guy. He about to mess us up. Because the people shouting to the king, Landra, we already got a king. Wait, we got to do something with him. And don't you know this? Let me tell y'all something. When people know that you have favor on your life, they will always try to plot to bring you down. Some of y'all know on y'all jobs, amen, you think everybody kikiing in your face, everybody laughing in your face, they just trying to get close to you in order to find out how to destroy you. There's always some people in the crowd that's on the other side. There's always some people in there on the other side. Care how close to, they could be your family members. Be careful. Said Jesus found a young donkey and sat on it. As it is written, for fear no more, daughter of Zion. Look, your king, that controversial word, is coming sitting on a donkey's coat. Now this is the thing that got me. Look right there in verse 16. That his disciples did not understand these things. They didn't understand why these people were shouting Hosanna and putting these palm branches down in front of him. So if the disciples didn't understand it, guess what? The people didn't understand it. Oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. There are some people that just do what they do without an understanding. Some people don't even understand why we're supposed to do what we're supposed to do. Maybe that's why you don't do it. Maybe that's why you don't praise God. And Adrian, maybe that's the problem. I would contend for those who come into the house and don't want to praise and worship. Because this is the house where you're supposed to come and pray. It may be because you don't know. You just show up because you know you're doing something. We got too many people that do stuff that don't know why they're doing what they're doing. Amen, somebody. Disciples didn't even know, but it says it gives us a preview into the future. When he was glorified, it said they understood. Now go home and read all of that. You'll see what's happening. And then you'll go home and read. Then we find ourselves down here, verse number 35. Jesus is talking about the crowd and how he's going to be glorified. And Jesus' father, after he said, now is my time, even though Jesus' soul was troubled, you all. His soul was troubled about what he was going through. This shows his humanism. Jesus was just like us. Hebrews tells us we have a high priest that can identify with us because he was human. We all have the Spirit of God. We have access to the Spirit. But he said, my soul is troubled. He said in verse 27, but what should I say? Father, save me from this hour. He said, I can't say that because this is why I came. He said, Father, glorify me in your name. People around him, just like Jesus heard the voice from heaven say, I have glorified it. And I will glorify it again. Crowd standing around heard it. They said it was thunder. Others said an angel has spoken to him. Jesus responded in verse 30, the voice came not for me, but for you. There are some things that will happen. It's not for the believer, but it's for the unbeliever. That's why we need to tell our testimony. Because it's not for me to get the glory, but it's for God to be glorified through me to show you what God can do. And then that's what Jesus said, if I'm lifted up from the earth, I'll draw all men unto me. Go home and read. I gave y'all enough. They said, wait a minute, but we thought we read in the word that the Messiah is going to reign forever. They said, wait a minute, who are you talking about? You this Messiah, but you talking about you finna die? How is that so? And Jesus didn't even answer them, you all. But what he did say in verse 35, he said, Jesus answered. And sometimes when you're talking to people, you don't have to ask, answer their ignorance. That's a word for somebody. When you hear them talking, thank you, Holy Spirit, that may have been for me. Amen. When you hear people saying certain stuff, you don't have to respond to their ignorance. Jesus didn't even respond. Now, ignorance is not a derogatory term. It simply means you don't know. You have not been enlightened. You just don't know. You don't understand. So that's a word for somebody. If I ain't said no, don't respond to people's ignorance. So Jesus said, the light will be with you only for a little while longer. I'm just about done now. He said, walk while you have the light so that darkness doesn't overtake you. Darkness is always associated with evil or untruth. He said, the light is with you. I'm here. He said, I won't be with you that much longer. Y'all talking about the wrong thing. Y'all focused on the wrong stuff. Jesus said this then. He said, the light will be with you. Walk in the light. So if you're going to let light in your life, the first point, easily, I'm just going to read the text. It, little Sunday school lesson. Look at your neighbor and say, walk in the light. To walk in the light, you all, means that, watch this, not with the light. I need to make these small distinctions. I'm done. Don't walk with the light because some people, Bernie, think it's just all right to be in his company. But you have to walk in the light. For all y'all English majors, in is a preposition. It shows placement. It means that I am walking in his word. Y'all come on a little closer. Because there's a whole lot of people when you read, I'm almost done, really, about 5 more minutes. I wish the keyboard was on so Adrian could play me some soft music. Because I'm almost done. Walk in the light, in his teachings. Jesus said in John 15, if you keep on reading, he said, I am the vine. Ye are the branches. If you abide in me and I in you, guess what? You can ask what you will. Therefore, you all, he says, not with, but in. And I'm saying that because some people think they could just come to church. I'm sorry, I'm not come to church because the church is the object and it can't be the subject for all y'all English majors. Come to the building where the church gathers. Some of us think that's just enough. That's walking with the light. But not in the light. In the light is to ingest and digest his teachings. That's why Bible study is so important. Sister Lynette, he says in John 14, Keep on reading. He says, Lord, how will you abide with us forever? He said, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. He said, but if you don't love me, you won't keep my teachings, my sayings. But in order to keep them, you got to get them. You can't save no money if you never have no money. You can't keep the word until you get the word. I wish somebody understand. So you have to walk in the light, not just with the light. Don't just be around it in its teaching. Then he says right there, I'm just reading the Bible. Y'all don't mind. He said, because I won't be with you that much longer. He said, but we don't want darkness to overtake you. The one who walks in darkness does not know where they're going. Told you, that's why you don't have to talk to people who talk ignorantly. They don't know where they're going. Stop frustrating yourself. If they don't want to be enlightened, amen, that's on them. Thank you. Help me preach, Demetrius. Don't let people frustrate you. They don't know where they're going. That's why Jesus, when he was on the cross, he said, Father, forgive them. They know they're ignorant. In verse 36, it said, while you have the light, my next point is this. I don't have them on the board, but y'all can write it down. Not only just walk in the light, then trust in the light. Because some people will say, oh, Reverend, I got it. I can quote a few scriptures. Yes, I can. But most people deny it or they doubt it. You got to believe the full gospel. You got to believe the entire Bible. The Bible is not something that you just pick and choose what you want to believe. As much as it talks about healing and deliverance and love and peace and giving, it talks about all of it. Too many of us have been picking and choosing what we want to believe. But you got to trust the whole word of God. Trust in the light. Don't doubt it. Don't deny it. Thank God we're living in a day where the Holy Spirit lives with us. I know he was talking to those people back then, but those people were in darkness. He was trying to lighten them up, just like I lighten the room of my house when I open the light and I allow it in my life. Then if you walk in the light, not just with the light, but in it. If you trust in the light, don't doubt it. Don't deny it. Every iota of the word, I believe. Every part of it. We just have to get understanding of what we believe. Then, somebody say then you will be children of light. That means you'll be his representatives. Then you will understand why we cry Hosanna. Then you will understand why we lift our hands. Then you understand why we commit ourselves to the work of the Lord. Because I'm a child of the light. You ought to know that God has charged us to be representatives of that light. Go home and read along with your reading. Go home and read 2 Corinthians. The fifth chapter, starting at verse 17. Y'all know the first verse. It said, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. He's given us the ministry of reconciliation. Guess what? He's given us that ministry. And he tells at verse 21, Dana, that we are ambassadors for Christ. That means I'm a representative. And if I'm a child of light, that means everywhere I go, I take my light. No matter where I am, on the airplane, wherever I go, in the grocery store, even in my house, I'm a representative of that light. Even when darkness tries to overtake me, when it can't tame my tongue, amen, somebody. When I want to do certain things, the light rises up in me because I'm a representative. I'm a child of light because I walk in the light. because I trust in the light, then I'm a child of that light. That old song, Adrian, helped me. It said, walk in the light. He was already playing it. Jesus, I'm through, y'all, is the light of the world. If we can sing it together, walk.
Walk in the light.
The beautiful light.
Beautiful light.
Come where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright.
Come where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright.
Shine all around us.
Shine all around us by day and by night.
Jesus.
Jesus, the light of the world.
Let's sing that one more time. Everybody that know it, walk.
Walk in the light. Beautiful light. Come where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright.
Shine
all around us by day and by night.
Jesus, loop that right there.
Jesus,
the light. Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh.
Jesus.
Jesus, the light.
Jesus, the light of the world.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for a reminder of who you are and who we should be. Thank you as we celebrate this Holy Week, as we remember your triumphant entry, but also the tragic events that happened at the end of that week. But then on that Sunday morning, you had the victory. Father, help us to not be discouraged no matter what we have to face, because we walk in that light and the spirit of truth and the spirit of freedom. Thank you, oh God, for being our light. Father, we pray for a spirit of openness in our minds and our hearts, that darkness would not overtake us, but we'll continue to walk in your light. We'll continue to trust in your light, and we will be representative children of that light. Father, there's somebody under the sound of my voice who've been walking in darkness, who's in transition. Lord, as we extend this invitation, we pray that they'll walk in the light, make that decision to trust in the light, and be a representative of that light. Thank you for what you have done, what you are doing, and what you will do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank God for those who joined us by way of Facebook, those who will watch our YouTube channel. We pray something was said to challenge you to change, motivate you to move, inspire you to be everything that God has created you to be. If you're looking for a place to worship, visit us at 3140 West 21st Avenue in Gary, Indiana. If you desire to be in fellowship with us, call us at 219-949-2225. Write us, email us, send us a Facebook post. To all those that are sick and convalescing, those who bereave, we want you to know that we are praying for you. Those who dub us as your Facebook church, thank you for the gifts that you send to this ministry. And we pray on this week that you will go throughout this Holy Week with a high holy attitude, knowing that you are distinctive, that you are different, all because you have allowed the light in your life. So don't let the day make the difference in you. You make the difference in the day. Put your hands together and let's thank God. There may be somebody in this house as we sing.
Good afternoon, New Revelation. I'm your news anchor, Damian Lee, here with your NRNBC News for the week. If you're interested in singing in the fellowship choir, please see Taisha Gardner or Kenesha Williams. Rehearsal will be Tuesday, March 26th at 7 p.m. Thank you from the Music Ministry. The Progressive Circle will have a meeting today following worship service, so please plan on attending. Please save the date. The Grief Ministry will be meeting on Saturday, April 6th at 12 noon. More details to come. The Layman Ministry is sponsoring their annual trip to the Chicago White Sox game on June 28th. The price is $80 per person, which includes an all-you-can-eat pregame food, buffet, and transportation. Payments can be made via Zelle, Cash, or Cash App. The deadline for payment is May 26, 2024. To reserve a ticket or for more information, please contact Bernie English at 219-588-0436. Bible study will be on Tuesday at 11 a.m. and Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. We would love to see you there. Now, at this time, we would like to recognize those members who are celebrating a birthday this week. The New Revelation Church family would like to wish a happy birthday to Sister Hortense Springfield. Brother Roosevelt Glenn. And Sister Betty Hicks. May you all have a wonderful time celebrating on your very special day. Now, if you have a birthday or anniversary in the month of March and you would like to be recognized, please see Sister Brenda English. New Revelation, let us continue to pray and offer our supports to the sick and the shut-in, their caregivers, the youth, bereaved, and those in prison. Well, this concludes the NRNBC News for the week. If you're watching and would like to contact or visit New Revelation, we're located at 3140 West 21st Avenue in Gary, Indiana. Our phone number is 219-949-2225. We would love to have you join us on Sundays. Our Sunday Bible Institute starts at 9:30 a.m. and worship service at 11 a.m. May you all have a wonderful and safe week. And remember, don't let the day make a difference in you, but you make the difference in the day. I'm Damian Lee. Take care, and I'll see you next time.